At this point, we know what the governing equations are that we need to solve. We have six partial differential equations and one algebraic equation. And we also know the domain over which we need to solve those solve the partial differential equations. It's a rectangle, as we saw. Let's next consider what are the boundary conditions we need to specify at the edges of the domain, and that would complete our specification of the mathematical model. So if I go to the domain, a schematic of the domain that I've shown over here, and I've indicated the heated part of the wall by this red line, and this is where the flow is coming in, and over there we specify the axial and radial velocity components and the temperature. We need to specify the temperature because we have turned on, the energy equation is being solved. If we didn't have the energy equation, then we wouldn't need the temperature boundary condition. Keep in mind that all these apply to Reynolds average quantities. I've been lazy here. I should be really putting the over bars. So in your mind, make sure that you realize these are Reynolds average quantities. And essentially, what we are doing with the velocity is we are specifying a constant velocity along the inlet, and it's supposed to be constant. And we know what that velocity should be because the mass flow rate is known from the experiment. So this value is calculated. This velocity value is calculated to match the mass flow rate that one determines from the experiment. And similarly, we know what is the temperature of the flow going in from the experiment. And where the flow is going out of the domain, it's common to specify the pressure, okay? And this is again a Reynolds averaged pressure. And that is known from the experiment because this location is at the exit of the adiabatic mixing section. So we know that value. We would know that value from the experiment. And then at the wall, we have the no slip condition. So both components of velocity are set to zero. And then the boundary condition for the energy equation, we have three different boundary conditions. The first part where you have just flow development with no heating, we have an isothermal condition. So we specify the temperature to be equal to the temperature at the inlet. The second part of the domain, there is a constant heat flux being added, and that's known. So this value is known from the experiment. This value is also known from the experiment, same as that. So coming back to this boundary condition, it's you know how it is a heat flux. You determine what is the heat flux that you're putting into the flow, and that should be equal to minus k dT dr from Fourier's law. This is the gradient, the temperature gradient normal to the wall. So essentially, what you're doing is you're setting dT dr. And over here, this is the adiabatic mixing section, so Q dot is zero, and in effect, dT dr is equal to zero. So that shows you what the boundary conditions are at the wall. And then at symmetry, Fluent will impose, the solver will impose that the normal gradients or the radial gradients are zero for the velocity, pressure, and temperature. And also that the radial velocity is zero because that's a symmetry boundary. Okay, so those are the boundary conditions for the mass momentum energy equations. And then you also need to give boundary conditions for the additional turbulence modeling equations, K and epsilon. And we need to specify K and epsilon at the inlet. Okay, so this is something we need to specify as users. And what we do is we pick values corresponding to low values of turbulence, because most of the turbulence is going to be generated in the boundary layers near the wall. And the idea is that if you put in low levels of turbulence, then your results are going to be relatively insensitive to these values, which you don't know. And that's something to check in verification. So that gives you an overview of the boundary conditions for this problem. And then as part of verification, we need to check that the solution agrees with these boundary conditions.